Thank you, Chairperson. Chairperson, the ACDP shares concerns that projected economic growth is down from 1.3% to 0.7% of GDP, and this will impact negatively on the fiscal outlook on job creation and poverty alleviation. Now, in February's budget, then-Minister Pravin Gordhan stated that the central fiscal policy objective is to stabilise the national debt-to-GDP ratio by closing the budget deficit. The medium-term budget policy statement, which we are considering today, presents a shocking state of public finances. The projected reduction of tax revenue of $50.8 billion in this financial year will result in fiscal slippage we were warned against. However, the figures snowball in the outer years, with tax revenue projected to fall short of projections by $69.3 billion in 2018-19 and $89.4 billion in 2019-2020. And we know debt service costs remain the fastest growing budgetary item, set to be $163.3 billion for this tax year. Now, this is a matter of great concern, and it is not sustainable in the long run, given the relatively low and small tax base in the country. And it will also crowd out other socioeconomic spending priorities. We also know that SOEs, and particularly Eskom, present significant threats to the fiscal outlook, given the substantial government guarantees that have been granted. Yet we've seen ongoing wastage and irregular expenditure, such as being unearthed in the Eskom inquiry. Eskom appears totally reliant on an increase in tariffs to sustain it. Yet why should the requested 19% tariff increase be granted, given what appears to be significantly poor governance and state capture at the SOE? It is no wonder then, and sadly, that S&P Global further downgraded South Africa's credit rating to full junk status last week, while its counterpart Moody's has placed the country on a review for a downgrade. This followed a similar sentiment by Fitch. Now, the Moody's decision to put the country on a review is a small but significant reprieve, and we as South Africans need to take full grasp of where we are. It saved the country from being booted out of the Citigroup World Government Bond, which would have resulted in obligatory capital outflows from South Africa of between $10 and $14 billion. And you can imagine what impact that would have had on our currency. Moody's stated that both low investor confidence and limited progress on structural reforms are rooted in the uncertainty created by their fluid and unpredictable political environment. We need to sort out policy uncertainty. We need to sort out political environment. The ACDP believes that this is one way to solve our problems. Member, your Thank time you very is much. Up.